Hello! In this video we will look at how a VPS server differs from a VDS server, as well as how VPS is more convenient for VDS. There are two types of VPS, with a shared processor or with a dedicated one. If you are running a VPS with a shared processor, then your server might be subject to some restrictions and encounter some issues. For example, your server neighbor can upload a virus into his system, because of which your server will also suffer, but not for long, because the VPS has limitations and actions, and the provider will quickly decide everything due to overload. But spamming can be very dangerous, because you and your neighbor will have the same IP address which can block your site or game server. I will show you how the creation of a VPS server with a regular processor looks like on the example of our site. To create a VPS server, go to our website server constructor and press the new instances button. Next, we need to select the operating system that will be used on the server. Then, choose a name for the server. Next, select the required number of cores, as well the amount of RAM and the amount of disk that we'll use on the server. The next step is to enter a password for administrator account. You can also enter SSH keys. The last step is to select the region where the server will be located and type of its network. There are four available server locations regions. Next, you will need to wait for the creation of the server. After the server has been created, you can see that a price has appeared indicating how much money it spent per hour and month on this server. Also, this data can be tracked in the payment sections. Let me show you what separate servers looks like for rent. To do this, let's go to our other site where you rent servers separately. Here we need to click on Place New Order. After that, we will be shown the types of servers for rent. Here, you can rent a VPS with a dedicated processor, a dedicated server, and other, many other features. The better the characteristics of the servers, the higher its price will be. Some servers include more traffic and additional IP addresses. Also here, you can rent the management of your server. Now, we will compare VPS and VDS, and then we'll talk about what is better to use and why. The first criterion is payment. VPS is paid hourly, VDS has a monthly payment. The second is to stop the server. Using VPS you will pay only for the IP address and allocated disk space, which is why the price will be lower than when it works. Using VDS you pay the same price whether the server is running or not. The third is the characteristic of the server. VPS has a limitation of 8 GB of RAM and 8 cores. VDS limitations depends only on hosting. The fourth is action restriction. VPS has restriction on user actions. The VDS has no restriction on user actions. You're provided with a server with a dedicated core, which is why there are no restrictions imposed. So question is the following: when is it better to use a VPS and why? Is VPS with shared processor sometimes better than a VDS? The first is payment. By renting VPS with a shared processor, you pay only for the hours of server operation and do save money. The second is time. If there are problems on your dedicated server, then you can quickly place your site on the VPS while they are being solved. Usually VPS is used on an ongoing basis either by individual users to host their small site or companies that need to quickly replace their server with another so that users do not go to competitors due to problems. If you want to use VPS for a long time, then you should take into account the load of your site. This is due to the fact that VPS has limited characteristics and will not be able to maintain a site with large number of users for a long time. If you are going to host a site with large number of users at a large database, then it is better to use VDS. VDS is the same VPS, but with a dedicated processor, and because of this, It is not subject to restrictions from provider, since your server will have its own processor. In principle, the rent of the VPS and VDS is very good for various reasons. For example, in case of a breakdown of some equipment, you will not have to replace it. Hosting is engaged in this. Hosting also have protection against DOS attacks, and you don't have to deal with the server management. You can rent this service. In general, VPS and VDS differs not so much, and your choice should depend on how much money you are willing to spend and how fast do you need a server. Yet the VPS with the shared processor is created faster than the VDS, and it will be the faster to host a site, and so on.